man, I really like Falls Creek area. Maybe one day when I fully retire, move into one of these buildings down here, just walk on the seawall every day. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is Henry. So we're back in Falls Creek. So last time we were here, we were diving underneath this dock right here, and we left a whole bunch of stuff down there because we were physically stuck to the ocean floor, surface tension, as well as just layers of mud and silt holding the things down. So I've talked to the City of Vancouver. We're going to use mechanical means, winches, to bring the stuff up. The problem is that this seawall right here has a load limit, and they can't bring their big truck on there with the winches on it. So what they have to do is they have to use ATVs, but ATV has the winch themselves, the lead on the winch only has a certain amount of reach, so they can't quite reach down, and we have to figure out how to get the line over the side. So I'm meeting them in about 15 minutes. I'm going to talk that over, but after the meeting, I am hoping to do a dive down here. It's not looking forward to this because the visibility sucks right now. Hang on, let me show you guys. So basically, all along this entire seawall right here, I'm really, really curious what is underneath all of that, because you can see the seawall. You see people walking on the other side. You can see the seawall just keeps going. In fact, it keeps going around the entire shore. It goes towards the BC Place over there, and so I'm really curious to know if other things have been discarded into the water. Not really looking forward to this because this visibility looks horrible today. Maybe a couple of feet at best. I'm hoping that once I get low enough into the water, I can dip below the crappy visibility. Yuck. All right, waiting for the City of Vancouver guys to get here, and then after our meeting, I'll go for a dive. All right guys, just finished my meeting with the City of Vancouver. You can see all the safety vests back there. Got the park staff, the arbor staff, the city staff. Yeah, so we kind of figured out what kind of winching system we're gonna use to pull up the rest of the garbage, and then we just have to worry about protecting that railing. We don't want to beat the crap out of city property. So anyway, I'm gonna get changed, get dressed, and get ready to do this murky, muckly dive. All right, see you guys in the water. Oh, I should mention, I'm not going to attempt to bring out garbage, but if I see something, just like singular thing, I'll probably end up bringing it out. I'm not trying to retrieve a whole bunch of trash today. This is more of a survey dive. Well, it's time to go for a splash, and let's see what there is in the water. The visibility is just as bad as I thought it was going to be. The GoPro camera I use actually picks up a lot more than what I can see with my naked eye. I actually didn't see any of this stuff as I descended into the water column. I didn't see any of that piping. I saw the bike because I recognized the shape, but I didn't actually see any of the other stuff at all, which is kind of interesting. So the rough plan for me is to go down the dock and just see what's underneath the dock, which I had a pretty good idea. This is the pipe that I saw, and that I thought there was a battery next to it, and Otto ended up recovering that pipe on the following dive, but he didn't find the battery. I think the battery is actually a little bit further on, but I swear the battery is right next to that pipe. I mean, the pipe could have moved. It is round and can move around with... There's the battery. So I gotta go back and find the battery. So there's a chair, and I did actually run into a few pilings here, so I knew that I was actually on the right direction, in the sense of I'm going along the perimeter of this area, but I did have to come up at a couple of times just to see exactly where I was, because I wasn't 100% sure. So I knew I was next to the pilings, I just didn't know like how far along the pilings I got. So this is like not the far end, but to the east, as far east as you could go in that little bay. And I saw this rope, and I said, oh, that's interesting. I wonder what that is. So I started pulling on it. I mean, really, I had no particular direction that I needed to go. So I figured, well, why not? Let's just go see what this rope is attached to. So as it turned out, I had to go actually quite a ways. As it turned out, it was actually attached to this giant ball of this what we typically refer to as anchor balls. And anchor balls are basically several anchors that are caught on each other. They have to be abandoned over time. And that just looks like a total mess. And there's like electrical cords, there's ropes, there's actually at least two anchors that I can see in there. So I thought, well, what I'll do is I'll see where this is located in the water. And so I came up to the surface and noted I was whatever number of feet away from the from Science World. So I scooted over to Science World to one of those booms there, and then I just tied off the rope underneath in the water. And I just tied it off there, and I kind of figured, okay, well, the next time when I come back to get that, I'll at least be able to follow that yellow rope. So now I'm scooting across the bay. So in the video here, as you can see with the GoPro, and this is with the light adjustment and everything, you can obviously see it's an engine. I actually didn't know that was an engine. I thought it was a piece of transmission for some reason, just because of the poor visibility. Remember, the camera is about maybe 8 inches above my eyes. So the GoPro camera is a little bit out of the silt, and my eyes are actually in the silt. So I attached my lift bag to it, lifted it, got it off the bottom, and then just used a scooter, just scooter myself back across the bay. And once I hit the pilings, I knew that I was next to my starting point. Just have to come up to see where, and I missed it by a little bit. So you can see that's where I needed to be. And surprise, surprise, there's Vancouver Harbor Police right next to me. I had my regulator in my mouth. I didn't want to take it out of my mouth because I didn't want to get the water in my mouth. So I didn't bother responding to them. Plus, with my hood on, I can't hear anyway. So I scooted back to the dock, attached the what I thought was the transmission block to the dock, so I didn't have it float away. And then the officer was nice enough to help me out of the water, and then as well as pull the, and now I actually recognize, oh, it's an engine. So I ended up having a nice conversation with Sergeant Darren McDougall of the Vancouver Police Marine Unit, and he gave me his card and we stayed in contact.
All right, guys, that was an interesting dive. Had the harbor police, who happened to be doing patrol in the area, basically getting those derelict boaters to move. And so they were like, holy shit, there's somebody in the water. Anyway, they came over and helped me out, and they were super nice to me. They came over and helped me pull that motor out of the water, so I didn't have to do it myself. And then there's a city vegetation worker guy. He actually helped me carry it all the way up here, because the sanitation guys told me to leave it on the dock and they'll come and get it. But I don't trust those boaters, man. They'll come over and do something stupid. So anyways, I pulled it up here. Let me show you what I brought up. So there we go. A little kicker motor thing. So the plan was to actually leave all of the garbage that I surveyed, and I found mountain bike, additional dollies and carts and shopping carts and all that. The plan originally was just to leave everything there, except this motor was in the middle of the bay, and I just knew there's no way I'll find it again, because I mean, it's in the middle, there's no reference points or anything, wasn't close to any piling. So but I found but identified mountain bike next to and carts and batteries and stuff like that. The battery that I couldn't find last time, I found it this time. I know where it is now. And that giant pile of anchor. The guy on the far side, the real nasty looking dude, I think he's anchored to it. But the harbor police, I asked him, I said, well, should I just leave that then? The harbor police like, nope, take it out. And I'm like, all right, whatever. But I'm calling you when I'm coming, because I don't want to have to deal with that guy. Anyway. That was a fun dive. It's starting to spit rain a little bit. And it was kind of fun. I got one piece of garbage out. That's good, right? Okay. Oh, okay. Good God. Okay, thanks to my Patreon supporters. We'll see you guys in the next one.